How important are MAT1A SNPs to methylation? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Marcus Matthiessen says, what are your thoughts about the significance of MAT1A SNPs as it relates to methionine metabolism and methylation? So these, in principle, could reduce the activation of methionine, deacetyl-methionine, but I don't know that there are any studies that have looked at whether that's the case. And so just because a SNP is in a gene doesn't mean that it reduces the activity of that gene. In fact, it doesn't mean it does anything even to the protein sequence of the gene, because a lot of SNPs don't affect the protein sequence, and that's because there are redundancies in which codons, which are triplet sequences of DNA bases that code for a certain amino acid. There's redundancy in which codons code for a SNP. And then not all changes in the amino acid sequence necessarily change the functionality. And then on top of that, not all changes in functionality are clinically significant. But I would just forget clinical significance. Some of these SNPs might not do anything to the functionality of the protein at all. What are my thoughts? I think someone should study whether they affect the genetic, whether they affect the functionality and whether there's anything to do about it. If you have SNPs in that area and you want to try CME to see if it helps, by all means, be my guest and try it. But I wouldn't go diagnosing people with MAT polymorphisms and then giving them treatment protocols over it. I think that's way overstretching the evidence. Thank you, Marcus, for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. For the remainder of 2020, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.